Opportunity to speak in such an important subject under Rule 193. Sir, pollution and climate change have definitely been one of the most important problems, not just for this country, for the entire global world also. And I'm glad that this discussion is happening today, because it's the need of the hour. And it's very delightful to see some of the suggestions and the way people have responded towards this debate. They want, they were showing hope that there is still a chance for us to act and to show a better way forward to the future generations also. And I would like to be part of that speech, the bigger debate of helping this country move forward in the right direction, sir. And definitely the alarm bells went ringing after the recent Delhi scenario that has happened. But I don't think anyone would disagree when I say that this, the smoke that has come up in Delhi is not just happening here, sir. The fire is lit all over the country. This situation that is happening in Delhi, maybe it's in a slightly ahead of times here because of the population, because of the way things are moving forward, but definitely we see this scenario hitting even the rural villages of this country. So definitely it is time we need to act on this on a very serious note. And more than the attitude of this country, the government of us, it all has to change, sir. Definitely we can speak on this issue. We have seen many good solutions that have come forward. So the attitude should be not about what we are saying, but the attitude should change to what we are doing for this. So that is the need of the hour today, that we move into what, how do we address this and what do we do in terms of this. Because environmental consciousness is present across the world, and it has been a very primary concern for the last 40-50 years. But if you consider India, sir, India, the Indian culture is very much in the DNA, in our culture, that we have respected environment, we have respected, even if you look at our traditions, our culture and everything, it comes with the basic connection with the nature. So we are proudly associated with the nature, but somewhere in the last 30 odd years, in terms of achieving growth, in terms of achieving development, and in terms of copying the Western world, we have somehow missed the link with the nature, and we haven't been on the right path. That much we can say, sir. So that is why there is the responsibility on today's government to take some extreme steps also. And I would like to quote a couple of lines, a couple of ideas from our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhiji, also, where he said that nature has enough to satisfy one's needs, but not to satisfy everyone's greed. That is an important words coming from Mahatma Gandhiji, sir. And he also pointed out in Indian opinion dated 1st February 1913, and this is in 1913, sir, that he said, the structure of the human body requires three kinds of nourishment: air, water and food. Of these, air is the most essential. Consequently, nature has provided it to such an extent that we can have it at no cost. But modern civilization is putting a price even on that. And that is happening today also, that there is a price on air, sir. And if you look at it in depth, this thing, sir, the country, you can say the society was divided because of the economic, financial situations. There are the rich, there are the poor, there is the affordability, there is the standard of living. But now you see in terms of environment also, this economic divide is creeping in, sir. A hard-earned laborer, a hard-working laborer, can't even have the access to fresh air, where he is not even responsible for creating any kind of pollution. He is just sweating it out day in and day out, and working hard to earn that money. And he is just sleeping outside to get a good fresh air and good night's sleep. And he is not even able to do that. The rich are able to buy gas chambers, the rich are able to buy the air purifiers, the rich are able to take a detox vacation to some islands or some places where they can get fresh air. But what about the poor of this country? And the recent Delhi situation is a very, very big example of people not even being allowed to go to school, not even being allowed to play. That is the kind of situation this environmental effects will have on a society and on the future generations also, sir. So that is why this shouldn't just be looked upon in a very narrow way. Things are much broader than the way they look, sir. And My request to the central government would be to create a national action plan, or let us say some environmental policy, or to that extent, if they are very willing enough, to create some kind of law where there is an abiding document where the people of this country will follow and there is strict measures. Because I would like to appreciate the efforts of the Honorable Prime Minister also. He has been going across the world and talking, saying big things that we are going to be committed towards this, we are going to be a role model. But look at this, sir. We have gone to the Paris. Sir, please. 5 minutes, sir. We'll discuss that. I'll speak, sir.
So many speakers
yes,
are there.
Yes, I understand,
please.
Sir. I'm a constant.
Don't encroach there.
I'm a constant victim of this time, sir. So let me speak. let's create a law. Let's create a law and let's use the principle of polluter pays, sir. Because whenever an environmental policy is being built, the core of any policy has always been that whoever is going to pollute, he is going to pay the price. And whoever is going to help in saving the nature or in helping the combat this kind of problem, he is going to be incentivized. So let us go with this kind of principle in whatever this thing that we want to do. And some of the stakeholders that we have to keep in mind. One is the farmers, and many of them have also raised up. Farmers are being affected by this problem, sir. Recently we have seen in Maharashtra, and it happened in my constituency, Srikakulam, in Andhra Pradesh also, due to unpredictable rains, the farmer had to pay the price. He has no solution to this kind of unseasonal rains or cyclones or natural disasters that are happening because of the climate change. So definitely the government has a responsibility to today take them into account and to create a sustainable examples to take them forward also, sir. And the other one is the fishermen. And I have to wish them, because today is the World Fisheries Day also, sir. So definitely there has to be a discussion on them also. Due to the rising sea levels because of the climate change, and the most affected will also be the fishermen. Their livelihood, their security of having a home, these are all affected. So definitely when we are creating a policy, these things, the stakeholders should also be kept in mind. And one other idea that we have to certainly discuss, like we are discussing pollution today, we have to discuss about the population also, sir. Last 30-40 years, population has been increasing at a
now
very exponential rate. Sir, 2 minutes, khatam karta hu. Ek hi page hai, sir, 2 minutes. And population ke baare mein main bata raha tha.
Two minutes,
I am concluding, sir. Next time we'll come up with a big number, sir. We didn't know that our time will be so much affected. We'd have paid more concentration on sir. So population, because of the increase in population, there is a lot of stress on the environment, on the resources that we're using, and the way the population is increasing in the next 30-40 years, it is very difficult to understand the scenario that the country might be facing, sir. So that is why I request that in terms of being a world leader, we have to take some strong steps in dealing with this problem, sir. And the other one other important issue, sir, and when creating this policy also, the states need to be taken aboard. And one problem and an example that I would like to take, the state of Andhra Pradesh also. Previous Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu Garu, when he introduced the PPAs with some companies, sir, to establish renewable energy, those PPAs are being revisited by the present government, sir. And because it is not able to understand that ultimately it's going to benefit the government and the people of Andhra Pradesh. They are getting into nitty-gritty which is not helping neither of them, not the government and not even the investors. It is doing that, sir. That is why I request the central government, whenever these situations, everyone should fall in line. The central government has the primary responsibility. Now you can't say Gujarat is producing so much solar energy, Andhra Pradesh is producing so much wind energy. We have to see a situation where all the brothers and sisters of this good nation are being part of it. Even Himachal, even the Northeast, everyone should be a part of this. So this will only happen with effective policy, sir. And that is the responsibility of this thing. And where do we start, sir? We start from right here, right now. And we already have a proposal of building a new parliament. So let us build a green building. Let us start from here. Let us have a good concepts which can be a role model for until not the parliament, secretariat or whichever new building. This is the building. This is the building. Whatever new we are building, let us have a green building, sir. Let us come up.
So I'll just conclude, sir, then.
I'll just conclude, sir, that it has been a wonderful debate, and it has been really, I appreciate each and every comments that have come from all the sides, sir, and I hope through the chair that the government is going to take this seriously and come up with innovative steps which is going to make our future generations proud, sir, because they are all so much worried about the future. It is our responsibility
that we take
care
of. Only four minutes.
बहुत धन्यवाद अतिथि, मैं आदरणीय राम जी के और